What's your marriage like?
Compromise.
Sometimes you just need to sit with yourself, or you just need to look into the mirror and tell yourself ki you're good. You're doing very good.
This Diwali, in addition to the long list of Ashirvads my dadi gives, she has added a new one, which is Vela Vela Lagan Dhe Jai, which translates into English as quickly, quickly get married. And I died laughing because I am unable to have enough bandwidth to at least deal with my own life as a 28-year-old functional adult working woman. Ye wo. And I'm like, is sab mein, where am I supposed to find somebody to spend my whole life with, right?
Yeah.
And I think everybody in their 20s and 30s has faced this kind of marital pressure from their families. So we put out a question on social media and we got some interesting responses. So I would like you to read them out.
The effort you put in working, you should put it in finding yourself a groom. Jitna kaam kar rahe utna hi effort pati dhoondne mein lagao.
Someone at an engagement party once told me, I am the only one left unmarried in the group. So it was time to compromise and not be so picky about men.
Oh God.
And that I should get married to the first boy who show interest. This is so mean, huh?
दरवाजे से जो पहला बंदा आया उसके साथ डेट कर लेना.
That at that rate you must be getting a lot of DMs. Ma'am, marry me, तुम किसको हाँ बोल दोगी? That's like. And we also asked people on social media another question, which is, what excuses have you used to wiggle out of this marital pressure situation?
The money you want to spend on the wedding, give it to me.
Yes.
I'll travel instead. You'll end up saving money and I'll be happy. So nice.
Correct.
I love this.
Instead
we
of,
should put it on our doors in our house.
Yeah, instead of 500 people coming and eating for free, I should travel for 500 days and eat over there with that money. Go for it,
Go
Sanya.
For it, young girl.
I have 5 tattoos. Now which good boy will want to marry me? I have 2 and I'm planning to get more.
So you have to get a guy who has tattooed also.
Yeah, or if
tattoo
he's fine
tattoo.
With it.
Tattoo to tattoo, I love that. Or a guy who doesn't care if you have 1 or 2 or 5 or 10 tattoos.
Kids say, yes, I'll get married. Adults say, no, I won't. Legends like me, I give them the example of their own marriage as a reason to never get married.
Recently, both my parents, after spending a lot of time in lockdown with each other, getting fried and doing everything together, and they have both come around to me separately and be like, don't get married, don't get married.
I had this friend, couple friend from Delhi, who was staying next to me here when I came to Bombay. I had a friend. But I never felt like that towards him. So they used to tell me, his wife used to tell me, "Arey kar lena shaadi, usse shaadi kar li." He's a very nice man. He's very. I used to like him also, but nothing more than that. You know, like they are after me. Nee nee, अच्छा है bachelor है, मतलब उसका कुछ नहीं है. कर लेना तू, बड़ा अच्छा है ये है वो है. पैसा भी है, flat भी है. So मैंने कहा यार, but I don't love him like that. You know, I don't lust for him or love him. तो उसने बोला, शादी के बाद प्यार भी हो जाता है.
This is our
traditional
culture,
but
it's a nightmare to be honest.
So many times, especially in our culture, I think parents have like planned their lives for their children, being like, okay, 18, you'll graduate, you'll do arts or science or whatever they've decided, and then you'll find a nice girl or a nice boy, and then you'll get married. How do we deal with this kind of structure that's been imposed on us?
They've been brought up like that, that this in society, if you have to live, you have to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. So it's not very easy to change their mindset. But I think time has come when you have to try and talk to them. You might not succeed, but beginning has to be done.
It's very important to have very understanding parents also.
And you've never had to tell or give any excuses to any of your extended family or relatives?
No, it took time for my parents to wrap their head around what I was trying to explain them.
Right.
About my views on marriage or my career and how I see it. Now they understand me, but it took time. There are times where my parents have also seen so many examples around us, so many failed relationships, that thing has also changed their thinking about it. I personally have seen a lot of like failed marriages. So putting pressure or forcing someone to get married won't help. And as we were talking, like love or just the family background, it's not the major thing. There is a lot that is required to run a companionship.
Boyfriend of mine, we were fighting. And in this fight, he said to me very nastily, you are still on the shelf. never forget that.
I think the connotation is if like you're waiting to be picked up, because literally
it's
you so are
horrible.
On a shelf.
It's so horrible.
It's horrible.
Nobody's waiting to be picked
yeah,
up.
Yeah, I absolutely agree.
Okay, I also want to ask you a question.
Please do.
In my time, the live-in used to be very bad. No live-in. And they used to say that then it's very easy for the man to leave you and go away. But in a marriage, he's tied up, then it's very difficult for him to get out of it.
So I did live with somebody for 2 years. And they were really wonderful years. It basically felt like being married, because at the same time, my friends had actually gotten married. My best friend got married 2 years ago, and my partner and I started living together around the same time. And we would have the same stories to exchange with one another. So it wasn't much more different from getting married, except that I guess I did not have as much of an obligation to the other person's family.
But you still believe that it's better to get married than just live in?
No, I don't believe that. Absolutely not. I read about a couple, in fact, in Kerala. They got married when they were 80 or something, after years of being together, having children, grandchildren, everything.
Yeah, recently, right?
They got married because for legal reasons. Unko kuch property papers and all they had to sort out. So they were like, okay, now we have to get married just for on paper to pass on our property. I was like, that's beautiful. So I'm also happy to live like this forever. Neena ji, if you don't mind me prying a bit, what's your marriage like?
Compromise.
ये तो बिल्कुल अच्छा नहीं लग रहा सुन के.
What are your favorite things about being married?
Companionship,
support,
somebody to lean on. We fight, we don't get along about so many things. Also, I got married very late. I got married when I was like 48 or something. So what I realized after a few years of marriage that you don't depend on your happiness on him. You do your thing. At least he's not stopping me from doing my thing.
I live alone in Bombay, and sometimes I feel that I need someone to be around, and not just my cat, but a human figure, Homo sapien around me.
So that maybe somebody who understands, like, कि मैं भी बिजी हूँ तू भी बिजी है वी आर गुड
या
वो होना पड़ेगा
वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट
दैट्स हाउ इट विल वर्क
व्हेन माय पार्टनर एंड आई डिसाइडेड टू टेक दिस टाइम ऑफ वी आल्सो अराइव्ड एट अ वेरीड ओपिनियन आई वुड से ही इज वेरी मच ऑफ द बिलीफ दैट इन 2 years आई वांट टू गेट मैरिड सो इफ इट्स नॉट यू आई एम गोइंग टू फाइंड समबडी एंड मैरी दैट पर्सन एंड आई एम वेरी मच लाइक आई डोंट नो वेयर लाइफ इज गोइंग टू बी इन 2 years सो आई कांट कमिट टू दिस राइट नाउ हैव एनी ऑफ यू एवर फेल्ट दिस प्रेशर फ्रॉम योर पार्टनर्स और
प्रेशर्स आर ऑलवेज देयर
I think if it's your decision to take it or not take it.
I've noticed something about me, what I do if I'm angry with my husband about something, which is very often. And I tell myself, okay, but he's very good like this, like this, like this, like this.
Huh. I do that also.
Hannah? And my anger goes.
Yeah.
This is being sensible, wise.
Practical.
Practical.
It's a sign of healthy relationship.
It's a sign of you being healthy. You have to decide. I want to make this relationship work.
Not then, giving up on.
Not giving up.
Yeah.
Not giving up.
Otherwise,
on
very easy
easily.
To give up. But this wisdom has come very late to me. I've done major mistakes in my life. You know, these kind of stupid mistakes.
So, Sanya, tell me, how do you deal with unsolicited advice about the matter, pressure from friends and family?
I think at the end of the day, you need to understand that it's your life. So all the decisions that you are going to take, you are responsible for it, right? You can't, if the relationship or the marriage you are in is not working and it happened because you took somebody else's advice, you would not be able to go and blame them. It's because of you I'm in it.
What your parents are doing, the spouse can also do. Pressure. In pressure, you will make more mistakes always.
At the end of the day, it's your life. Okay, even if you're getting that pressure, even if somebody is giving you that unwanted advice, take it. Scrutinize it. If it's not, discard it and take your own decisions. That is way, way more important than anything.